Write a formula for the nth term of the arithmetic sequences. And the first one is 100, 500, 900, 1300, and so on. Assuming the next one would be 1700, because it looks like we're adding 400 every time. The general form for an arithmetic sequence is that the nth term equals that first term, a sub 1, plus the difference, the arithmetic difference between each one, times n minus 1. So we can talk about that in just a bit, but let's just take that information and just plug it in. So we've got a difference we see of 400 from one term to the next, and we also see that our first term is 100. Okay, let's take that information and plug it into that general form. A sub n, the nth term, would equal 100 plus that difference of 400 times n minus 1. And certainly we can clean this up and distribute the 400, and we get a sub n equals 100 plus 400n minus 400, and then in the end we get a sub n equals negative 300 plus 400n. Okay, and that it seems weird to look at it just like that, but let's think about what's happening. If we plugged in 1 for n, that is, if we're talking about the first term, we would get 400 times 1 plus negative 300. And 400 times 1 is 400, so 400 plus negative 300 would give us our first term of 100. So this formula does work, and you can plug in n equals 2 and n equals 3 and so on. The reason this general form works is we know that we're going to be starting with the first term. That makes sense. And then we're adding some multiple of the difference. So we're adding either 400 or 800 or 1200 onto that initial term to find the nth term. And it's n minus 1 so that we don't add that difference right away on the first term. Because if we added difference, just difference times n, we would add 400 right away onto the 100, and that wouldn't get us our first term. Okay, so that's why that general form works. Let's use it for this next example and just pull out what we know. Looks like the first term, a sub 1, is 12. The difference is negative this time. In this sequence, 12, 6, 0, negative 6, negative 12, we are subtracting 6 every time. So that's the difference, is negative 6. So now we have the information, and we can just plug it right into that standard form, a sub n equals the initial term, the first term, plus the difference of negative 6 times n minus 1. And the form still stays the same, even though it's negative 6. Everything else of the form stays the same. We distribute that negative 6, and let's stay with the same color here, and we get a sub n equals 12 minus 6n, and then negative 6 times negative 1 is a positive 6, so we'll get a sub n equals 12 plus 6 is 18 minus 6n. And again, it seems a little disconcerting to see this 18 here, but if we plugged in 1 for n, that is to find the first term, we would have 18 minus 6. And 18 minus 6 is indeed 12. So this general form does work, and use it to find the nth term of the arithmetic sequences.